Hi.
Hello.
Hello, friends. We have our best friend Hank here. He is the mask. What do you call that? The mascot.
Yeah.
He's the mascot of this video. Can you say hi, friends? Hi, friends. So, friends, we're gonna talk to you guys about what our life was like back when we were 300 plus pounds and what our life is like now that we've both lost 130 pounds. So if you're new to our channel, Kyle, my husband, and I have both lost 130 pounds. This is our fifth year in our weight loss journey. We often get questions as to like what we don't miss about, you know, being heavier, what you gain when you lose weight. Losing weight, it's not just a physical thing. It's here and it's here. Fight through it. You can do it. Don't give up. We were completely miserable. First of all, sleeping was a complete nightmare because Kyle had acid reflux to the point where he would wake up choking on acid in the middle of the night, barely being able to breathe, scaring both of us to death almost. And then there was me who had sleep apnea and would wake up constantly. Well, first of all, I would stop breathing and Kyle would be scared all night long because I stopped breathing on average 7 times a night. So my brain shut down 7 times every single night. And 81 times a night, my brain semi-shut down. So I was constantly stopping breathing or partially stopping breathing every single night. And that was just sleeping. During the day, we could both barely walk up the stairs. We were out of breath constantly. We were always sweating. We could barely sit. We were at the point where we could barely sit in chairs without being afraid that we were going to break them. I was so embarrassed to go shopping. Most of our clothes were barely fitting to the point where I was afraid I'd have to go up another size or maybe have to get clothes custom made because I was just not fitting in things properly anymore.
Nothing at any normal stores would fit me anymore either.
No, and I was in plus size. I finally had to go to plus size stores, but I was constantly having to go up in sizes and it was really scary. Our seatbelt in the car, I was afraid that it wasn't going to fit anymore. It wasn't going to stretch over my stomach because my stomach was so big. Going anywhere that we used to enjoy, like Kyle and I used to love roller coasters, tobogganing, but our bodies wouldn't fit on roller coasters and they wouldn't fit in sleds.
And they couldn't handle walking around a theme park or a zoo or anything that we used to do.
No, the last place we went was the zoo. And we were dying. We barely made it. We were trailing behind our family, gasping. Our feet were so sore. It took so much out of us. Just to stand, just to do any like normal activities like dressing or showering or anything like that took so much energy out of us.
I gave myself type 2 diabetes. So again, nighttime was a nightmare because I was going to the bathroom 7 to 10 times a night.
Yeah, when you weren't having acid reflux, you were dealing with your diabetes. I developed plantar fasciitis so bad I could barely walk. It was so painful. I honestly thought I might end up with a walker or in a wheelchair because my feet were really painful.
So friends, you're talking to two people that have been there.
We were completely miserable and we were medicating with food all the time.
On top of the physical problems, we both had serious eating disorders.
Yes, we did. We had binge eating disorder. We had been struggling with eating disorders our whole lives. From very young, from 5, I dealt with an eating disorder and I went through all of it. I went through starving myself, through trying to make myself vomit, and then I turned to binge eating disorder, which I suffered with for the majority of my life until 5 years ago when we started dealing with it. But friends, if You know, we were at the bottom of the barrel and we honestly thought that we would never get better. We wanted to. We wanted to lose weight. We wanted to get in better shape. And we, you know, we were hopeful in thinking that it wasn't going to end like that. But we knew if we didn't change something, we would die. One of us would die, or both of us, from what we were putting our bodies through. And so when you think that it's hopeless, know that we are two regular, everyday people who were at the bottom of the barrel and didn't think they could get out.
Nicole got rid of her sleep apnea machine. She no longer needs it to sleep. I completely reversed my type 2 diabetes. My blood work is perfect now, to where, you know, I had type 2 diabetes. I had given myself that and I completely reversed it. So when you're struggling, just know you're talking to two people that have struggled as well. You're not alone.
Yeah, you're not alone. You don't have to go through it alone. And we were literally at the bottom of the barrel.
And that
we
was
dying.
That was only 5 years ago, friends. So we've completely turned our life around.
Our lives have completely turned around. We were completely miserable and now we are so happy and full of life. We live every day to the fullest. We can play with Hank. We can do so much. We just enjoy everything. We enjoy eating and working out, and we no longer use food to medicate. We can go to any store to buy clothes. We're not afraid to buy food or embarrassed. We enjoy eating all foods. We don't label foods anymore. We don't worry about, you know, what's in our food or obsess over what our weight is or what we're going to eat or what we shouldn't eat or what people think of us. We are so much more confident. I love shopping now. I love trying on different clothes, and our bodies are improving every day still. We love getting in the gym. We can move. We can walk for hours. Our bodies are healthy. We've pretty much reversed most of the damage that we've caused. Obviously some things still remain, extra skin, some, you know, injuries from being heavy, but those are so minor compared to where we were before. And we're so happy and healthy now, and we're helping other people. And we've always wanted to. We always said to each other, we will find a way out of this, and when we get healthy and figure it out, we want to help other people. And we're doing that now. So just know that even if you think that you can never come back from where you brought your body or yourself, Kyle, like Kyle said, it's only been 5 years and we've completely changed our lives. We did it and you can do it. And you're not alone. You don't have to suffer alone. We're here. We're real people who are honest, and we've gone through everything that you might be going through. And we're telling you, you can change your life too. It is possible. You can do anything you want. Don't give up. It's not easy. It's a difficult journey, and you will have bumps in the road. You will, you know, fall several times along the way, but you can get back up every time, and you'll be stronger. You'll learn from it. You know, it's normal to make mistakes, and you will. And that's good, because those make you stronger, and you learn, and you overcome it, and you're better.
And the best thing about this whole journey in life, you get to decide if you want to change your life. That's what clicked in our head. We finally had enough.
Yeah.
And we made the decision, we're doing it. We didn't know how, we didn't know when and where.
But we knew we were doing it.
Yeah.
So make your decision. Know you're doing it. Know you're getting out from the bottom of the barrel. Know you're getting to the top. Climb your way out, because you can do it.
And you're worth it.
And you are worth it. You deserve it. Have some compassion. Be gentle on yourself, and you can do it. And, you know, it doesn't matter if anyone else around you tries to drag you down. Just keep going. You can do it. We did it. You can do it too. So friends, we really hope that this video has motivated and inspired you and made you feel like you can do it and confident Know what you want and get it, friends. You can change your life any moment. You can say, you know, I'm done with this and I'm going to love my life. I'm going to live every moment the way it should be lived to its fullest.
It's never too late to turn it around, friends.
No, it's never too late. You can do it, friends. We're here for you. You're not alone. You never have to struggle alone. We are here. So we really hope that you enjoyed this video. You know, please feel free to leave your comments or questions down below. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Will you get this? This little sleepy mouth god of doom. Thanks so much for watching. Bye, guys.
Bye, guys.